Welcome back to another ride along, and welcome back to Texas and in my home zone. Right now it is almost 2 o'clock in the afternoon. I have been at it for over an hour, and first thing I did was go get the car washed, because after that trip from Colorado, actually I didn't even check to see how the front looked after the car wash. Although I did see the guy spend a little bit of time at the front, which was nice. Because sometimes they're just like, you know, they'll spray it. And then sometimes they don't even scrub it, or they'll just give it a quick scrub. But I didn't even check to see what the front looked like. But at the moment, I do have 5 apps open. And the first offer that I got earlier was from Spark. And as I was on my way to drop off, and it was just to a 2-customer drop curbside, I got an offer on DoorDash. So I was able to do a quick stack on that one. But I made those drop offs, and now I'm just in kind of one of my areas that I would normally wait. Whew, I tell you, my car is reading 90 degrees. And I say this is my car because we are still in ours and not my daughter's, so we still don't have any AC, so whew. But it is reading 90 degrees. We were really hoping that not necessarily a cold front, but those fantastic fall temperatures, like the low 70s, I thought that would be here, but no. Even before heading out earlier today, I did see that the forecast on the Weather Channel was saying that they were showing for the entire U.S., but I saw for specifically for Texas that is above average temperatures for warmer temperatures for the month of November and December. So what that means is, are we looking at, you know, 80s and 90s? Oh goodness, I hope not. But I'm hoping, like I said, it's already going on 2 o'clock. I've only gotten 2 offers so far. But I'm hoping I'll get, you know, a couple of more decent ones before I end this day shift. Because I don't know how much longer I can hang out in this heat. Especially since there's not really much of a breeze going on. But here's hoping we get, or I get, because the hubby's not with me right now. He did majority of the driving, so he's trying to relax. But I'm hoping I get a couple more offers before I end the shift. Hi. Delivery.
Okay.
It's supposed to be for Sarah? Okay. Alrighty, you got this Instacart offer. It is 35 miles. It's a total of about 22 items and a 3-customer shop. The first one is here at Costco, and it's only 11 items. And I barely made this one because I was in the middle of doing an Uber Eats drop. So let's get to shopping. Items.
They gave me 22 minutes
and I got it done in 17. Nice. All right, let's get checked out.
retired on a Spark, another one at least, but I'm in a different zone. That Instacart that I just finished ended up taking us to Killeen, and as soon as I was done dropping it off, I got this Spark order. One customer, 11 items, something like that, $15. All right.
All done and bagged.
Let's get to delivering.
All right, so now it is 6 o'clock, and so that Instacart offer that I accepted in our hometown ended up taking us to this zone that we're in right now. And as you saw in that previous clip, I got a shopping offer, and now I'm waiting on a curbside. It's actually gonna be a money stack because I've got this curbside here just for one customer. And my husband just went to a smaller, one of the neighborhood that's like 3 minutes from here, Shoe Bug. And he's doing a medium sized shopping order. So sometimes it just plays out. I don't say medium, I mean, it's less than 20 items really. And it's a neighborhood Walmart, so it shouldn't take him too long to do that. And it's less than a mile for his drop-off, so pretty cool. I like it when it works out like that. I mean, I checked in here. Like I said, it's just a one-customer curbside. And it's still showing that it's not ready. But, you know, in comparison to, you know, doing... Now that we've done three different states, our home state of Texas, we've done South Carolina twice, and now we are doing, you know, we've done Colorado, and it's interesting to see. I mean, I know just even from zone to zone, or even from store to store, things can be done differently because they're all under different management. So you got some stores that are, you know, pretty adamant about making sure that the Spark drivers are supposed to be doing what they're doing and who they supposed to be are. Wait, I didn't say that right. You know, basically checking IDs and stuff like that. So, I mean, it was just like when we were in Colorado, we worked two different zones, and, the first zone that we worked in, there was two. We visited two of the three stores, only worked one of the three stores in that zone. And, but, you know, the associate there, like you saw in that last video, if we can earn the same in Colorado. So if you haven't seen that, go check out that video. It was interesting just to see, I mean, it was nice to see that they check ID for sure. Whether they do that for that entire zone, I don't know, because we only worked one store of the three in that zone. And then the next day we had worked in a different zone, and we visited four. We went to four different stores in that zone, and I believe there was seven. And we worked three of the four. But it's, I mean, I know I've seen it on Facebook in the group talking about places that are bagless and what it can be like when doing curbside. You know, I've seen some comments where people say the loaders just bring out a cart full of groceries, nothing in bags. You know, thankfully in the one that we went to, the couple of stores that we did curbside at, even though they were in two different zones, they brought them out in bags. So I think my order's almost here.